JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 19th. I am Charalambos, head of research here at JFD. And I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar underperformed against all the other major currencies on Monday during the Asian session Tuesday. It fell the most against NZD, AUD, and the euro in that order, while it lost the least ground against the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the risk-linked TIIE and Aussie, combined with the weakening of the dollar and the yen, suggests that market sentiment turned to risk on at some point during the day. Looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that European shares closed in the red, perhaps as investors were still concerned after the weaker than expected growth data from China. The fact that oil prices hit fresh highs may have also dented sentiment during the European session, as it may have kept concerns over persistently high inflation elevated. However, the picture was different during the US session. Although the Dow Jones slid 0.10%, the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq finished their trading positive, with the appetite rolling into the Asian session today. It seems that better than expected earnings results from big US banks last week encouraged some market participants to start this week by increasing their risk exposure, as they may have become somewhat more optimistic over the rest of the earnings season. Analysts expect the S&P 500 earnings to rise 32% from a year ago. With several major indices around the globe breaking key technical resistance zones last week, we believe that more positive results could encourage more stock buying. At the same time, risk-linked currencies are likely to benefit, while the safe havens may stay on the back foot. However, as we noted last week, we are reluctant to call for a long-lasting recovery. We prefer to take things step by step, and the reason is that the fundamental background that triggered the latest correction in equities has not changed much. Oil prices remain elevated, which could still lead to further acceleration in inflation and thereby faster tightening by major central banks, while China continues to face several problems, from default risks in the property sector to tight regulations for tech firms and fresh lockdown measures due to the spreading of the Delta coronavirus variant. Now, speaking about central banks during the Asian session today, the RBA released the minutes from its latest monetary policy meeting, but as we have been expecting, there were no fireworks. Instead, the Aussie was found as the second best performing major currency this morning. Just for the record, the minutes confirmed that officials do not want to raise interest rates before 2024, noting that tighter monetary policy would lead unacceptably to fewer jobs and lower wage growth. Now, flying from Australia to the UK, tomorrow during the early European morning, the nation's CPI data for September are coming out. The headline CPI rate is expected to have held steady at 3.2% year over year, while the core one is anticipated to have ticked down to 3% from 3.1%. Despite the potential slowdown in underlying inflation, both rates are expected to stay well above the Bank of England's objective of 2%, thus If the forecasts are met, we doubt that they could alter market expectations around the Bank of England's future policy plans. With Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey and MPC member Michael Sanders expressing willingness to push the hike button soon, market participants are now anticipating a 15 basis points hike to be delivered before the end of the year. However, despite the latest rally in the British currency, as we climb higher, we will be more and more careful. In other words, we will continue aiming higher, but we are reluctant to call for a healthy, long-lasting uptrend. This is because we don't see much room for high expectations to come forward, and due to concerning headlines surrounding the UK economy. We may get a clearer idea on that from the preliminary PMIs for October due out on Friday. Now, as for the rest of today's events, the only data releases worth mentioning are the US building permits and housing starts for September, as well as the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. Building permits are expected to have declined somewhat, while housing starts are forecast to have fractionally increased. As it is always the case, no forecast is available for the American Petroleum Institute number. Now, as for the speakers, we have not one, not two, but eight officials on the agenda. From the ECB, we will get to hear from Chief Economist Philip Lane and Executive Board Members Frank Elderson and Fabio Panetta, while from the Bank of England, Governor Andrew Bailey will step up to the rostrum. In the US, the calendar points to speeches from San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly, Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic, Fed Board Governor Michelle Bowman, and Fed Board Governor Christopher Waller. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So, bye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.